We welcome you to the prayer with the anointing water here at the USA Good News Church. Anointing water is what Prophet TB Joshua prayed for and blessed for. In generations before, God has used the rod of Moses to split the Red Sea. God has used the water of to heal the Naaman. God has used the saliva of Jesus to open the eyes of the blind. He used the handkerchief of Paul to touch people who were possessed and people who were sick. And in this day and age, the Lord has blessed the anointing water through His servant, Prophet TB Joshua. And it's not the water that heals or delivers, it's Jesus Christ. Because anointing is only done in His name. Amen. And so what's expected out of you today is to look to God and to remember, it's not necessary for you to suffer the things Jesus paid for with the great suffering. Your sickness, your nightmare, the attacks of the devil, they are illegal in your body because Jesus has taken that upon Himself through the cross of Calvary in Jesus' name. Amen. So let's just pray this simple prayer where you will welcome Jesus into your heart. Say this out loud after me. Say, Lord Jesus, open my heart to your word. Lord Jesus, open my heart to your faith. Lord Jesus, open my heart to your spirit. Amen. Receive today in the name of Jesus.
Right now, the anointing water prayer line in the United States is beginning. What you're about to see right now is the Holy Spirit moving, operating in the lives of people through the medium of the anointing water. And as you can see, the evangelists are here right now praying for every person who has come here from far and wide, from all over the United States, to receive a touch from Jesus Christ. I want you to remember this morning that God cannot be limited by time or space. Distance is truly not a barrier to the move of the Holy Spirit. So you too, wherever you are, whether you are here, whether you are watching online, you can be a partaker of what is happening here today. The divine miracles, healing, deliverance, and breakthrough. This can be yours because we know that believing is our connection to Jesus Christ. So this morning, open the eyes of your faith. So because when we know we open the eyes of our faith, it is the silencing of our fears. And we allow the Holy Spirit to move on our behalf. And each person who has come here this morning is doing just that, to receive that divine touch from the Holy Spirit. We know that as we come here today, that because of Christ, we are eligible to receive of God's healing, deliverance, and breakthrough. Because of the blood of Jesus Christ, you and I are declared righteous. You and I are here today to receive from the Holy Spirit simply because of Christ. And Christ and the price that He paid. We know that Jesus Christ, He bought our healing, deliverance, and breakthrough at the price of great suffering. So we must receive from Him today. We must take it as a gift, as a special treasure from God to receive from Him. Right now, as you watch your screen, you can see the Holy Spirit at work. The name Jesus operating in the Spirit through the medium of the anointing water, touching this woman as she is being prayed for. As you can see, she's not at ease with herself. As the Holy Spirit begins to uproot and remove every single darkness from her life, what you're seeing right now is a spiritual combat. The Holy Spirit at work, moving in her life to remove everything that is not from God. Viewers, what you are witnessing right now is the real, authentic, and forceful power of God working in the lives of these people. You can see the Spirit of God moving as He continues to uproot every single darkness from this woman's life. Remember that you too can be a partaker of what this woman is receiving right here by simply connecting yourself in faith and receiving from Jesus Christ. You can see the Spirit of God working in the Spirit as the name of Jesus is working in the Spirit today, taking out every single thing that is not of God, removing every darkness. We know that where the light of God is, that no darkness can prevail. That we know that our victory in Christ Jesus is as sure as the rising of the sun. And we can stand confidently and boldly before the throne of grace to receive our miracle today. Faith is our connection. And we know that the Bible says in Hebrews chapter 11 that without faith, it is impossible to please God. Those who come to Him must believe that He is and that He is the rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. So this morning, you too can receive your reward by connecting yourself in faith, pleasing God in Jesus' mighty name. Deliverance continues right now as the Holy Spirit is combating the evil spirits and darkness that is affecting the lives of these people. We can see that the Holy Spirit is removing and uprooting every area of darkness from the lives of these people today so that they too can walk in their freedom. We know that today their testimony is being restored in Jesus' name. Restoration has come. Redemption has come. Healing has come. Deliverance has come in Jesus' mighty name. We know that we are able to receive from God based solely on the blood of Jesus Christ, not our own works, not our own deeds, but simply by the precious sacrifice of Jesus Christ. For we know that Jesus Christ has bought our healing and deliverance and breakthrough at the price of great suffering. So today we receive of His mighty plan today.
Jesus Christ. Fire of the Holy Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name. Who are you? Fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Get up. Get up in the mighty name of Jesus. Stand straight. Who are you? Who are you? Fire in the mighty name of Jesus all over your body. All over you. Fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Who are you? What is your mission in her body? Destroy. Say louder. You came to destroy. How do you destroy? Answer in the mighty name of Jesus. How do you destroy her life?
I kill.
You kill. How do you destroy her family?
Destroy.
How do you destroy her finances? Answer in the mighty name of Jesus Christ right now. You evil spirit, where is your mission in her family? Fire of the Holy Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Fire 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 in the mighty name of Jesus. You unclean spirit, you must leave right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every single one of you out of her body, out of her life in the mighty name of Jesus. Church, let's stretch our hands forward. Let's begin to command that evil spirit to come out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every single one of you, we command you out of her life. Out of her life in the mighty name of Jesus. Every unclean spirit, every demon in her life, every darkness hiding in her body, we command it out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Leave her right now. Leave her right now. Every single one of you, out. Every part of her body, out of every part of her being, out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Out right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Fire, 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 fire all over her body. Fire all over her body. You cannot stand in the arena of liberty. Fire, 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 fire. Out in the mighty name of Jesus. Every single one of you. Out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Out in the mighty. Fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. All over your body right now. Out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Fire all over your body. Fire all over your body. Out. You snake. Out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You unclean spirit. Out. Come on, church, let's continue to pray. Out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Out in the mighty name of Jesus. Leave your life. Leave your body. Leave her right now. Out. 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 Out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every single one. Out. Out. Out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Out of her body. Out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Turn it over. Out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every single one of you. Every single one of you. Out. Out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every single one of you. Out. Fire, Holy Ghost. Come on, church. Let's stretch our hands. Exercise the authority, believer's authority. Let's command that every single demon that's operating in this life will be out in the mighty name of Jesus. Fire, Holy Ghost. Fire all over your body in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every single one of you. Out. Out of her life, out of her mind, out of her body right now. Out. Out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Out, every single one of you. Fire of the Holy Ghost. Every trace of darkness. Every trace of sickness. Every trace of family curse. Out in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Out in the mighty name of Jesus. Fire of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Fire of the Holy Ghost. Every single one of you. Every trace of darkness. Every trace of darkness. Not one of you left behind. In Jesus' name. Out. Because of Christ, be free in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Because of Christ, be free in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We declare you free in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Come on, man. Get up on your feet. Come on, church. Let's put our hands together. Say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. I'm free.
Thousands were burdened with guilt because of their sins, but Jesus offered forgiveness. Thousands were spiritually starved, but Jesus said, I am the bread of life. Hundreds had bodies riddled with sickness and disease in Acts chapter 10, verse 38. But Jesus went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed of the devil.
Say, I am saved.
I am saved.
Jesus is my Savior.
Jesus is my Savior.
Say, I am healed. Jesus is my healer. I am delivered. Jesus is my deliverer. So my past is over. I am redeemed. I am justified. I am no longer condemned. In Jesus' name. Say, I will make God's word a standard for my life. I will go and sin no more. In Jesus' name. Now this is a good time to give Jesus a round of applause as you go back to your seat. And let's get ready for the next line in Jesus' name.
Welcome you once again to the prayer line with anointing water that Prophet T.B. Joshua has given us to pray for the people, for the sick, for those that are in need, for those that need freedom. It's not the anointing water that heals or delivers, but we know that anointing is done in Jesus' name. And like God used many mediums in the Bible, today He uses anointing water. But the anointing is done in Jesus' name. Jesus on the cross has paid a great price for your freedom, for your deliverance, and for your breakthrough. Amen? So today all you have to do is just receive it. No effort, no extra efforts needed. No extra things needed, no money needed. It's free because Jesus already paid the price on the cross. Amen? Let's open up in prayer. Repeat after me. Say, Lord Jesus, open my heart to your word. Say, Lord Jesus, open my heart to your faith. Say, Lord Jesus, open my heart to your spirit. In Jesus' name, be ready to receive.
The prayer line continues this morning as people come here from far and wide, from all over the United States, to receive a touch from the Holy Spirit. Each person is here believing that Jesus Christ has an answer to their problem. We know that Jesus Christ truly is the answer to all fundamental issues of life. So whatever your problem is today, whatever your situation today, your answer is Jesus Christ. Your answer comes only from Him who bore your sin and sickness on the cross. And today, because of that great suffering, because of the price that He has paid, because of Christ, you can receive your healing, your deliverance, your salvation, whatever it is you're looking for today, you can receive your answer because of Christ. So connect yourself in faith right now in Jesus' mighty name. Remember this morning that trusting in Christ Jesus is not a mere intellectual acknowledgement, but adherent to, commitment to, trust in, and faith and total dependence upon Him for everything. That is, you must depend upon Him to live, to move, and to have your being, because no state of being is as rewarding as living in tune with Jesus Christ. In other words, in coming to Jesus Christ for help and spiritual healing, we should have an eye to Him as the promised Messiah, the trustee of mercy and grace. Therefore, let the guilty, the empty, the naked, and the hungry be of good cheer and of comfort, for He calls them to be pardoned, filled, clothed, and supplied in Jesus' mighty name. What you're witnessing right now is the Spirit of God moving in the life of this woman, and the name of Jesus effectively working in the Spirit to remove every single area of darkness. Poisonous substances are being uprooted from her body, removing any sickness, any disease that was once plaguing her life. The word of God abiding in the medium of the anointing water becomes spirit through the spoken word as the anointing water and as the evangelist speaks to the evil forces in the lives of people in Jesus' name, thereby bringing Jesus on the scene. And when God is in the house, Satan and his agents must be exposed and expelled in Jesus' name. Prayer continues. We want to encourage everyone that is here this morning and that is watching us online to remain in an attitude of faith. We know that believing is our connection to Jesus Christ. It is important for us to have faith as we come here today, because we know faith is the currency of heaven, and it takes faith to receive from God. So we pray this morning in Jesus' name that you will have the measure of faith to receive from the Holy Spirit this morning. To receive your miracle, to receive your deliverance, to receive your healing, your salvation, and your breakthrough. So we know that as we come to Jesus Christ with faith in His Son and His precious sacrifice, that our healing, our deliverance, our breakthrough is as sure as the rising of the sun. So connect yourself in faith right now. Let faith overtake you. Let faith be a part of you. Let faith be on your lips as you stand here today to receive from God. Even in the crowd or watching online, let faith be the currency from which you receive from God. For we know that it is the only thing that pleases God when we come to Him. And you can come boldly before that throne of grace because of your faith in Jesus Christ. And we know that it's because of Christ that we are called righteous. It is because of Christ that we are here this morning ready to receive from God Almighty. So stand in faith today. Remain in that attitude in Jesus' mighty name. You can see right now as you watch your screen that every single darkness is being removed from the lives of the people. They're not at ease with themselves, as the evil spirits must be forced out by the name of Jesus Christ. So you can see the evangelist using the name Jesus, working in the spirit to uproot and thwart out every single darkness, because we know that where the light of God is, no darkness can prevail. So this morning, we invite the light of the Holy Spirit to come and break every single shade of darkness over our lives and over the lives of the people who have come here today. In Jesus' mighty name. As we're here today in the arena of liberty, I want to encourage you to confess your freedom this morning. Confess your faith in Jesus Christ this morning. Confess today is a good morning. So say good morning to your health. Good morning to your freedom. Good morning to your deliverance, because we know that His mercy is new every single morning. So as you are here today, say good morning to your miracle, because Jesus Christ is ready and He is willing. Just like the man with leprosy, he said, "Jesus, if you are willing," and Jesus' response was, "Yes, I am willing." So be healed in Jesus' mighty name. We know that the Spirit of God is willing to heal you. He is ready to heal you. And it is only your responsibility just to receive from Him by faith. For we know that Jesus Christ took up our sin and sickness on the cross. He bore all of our sicknesses. He bore all of our sins so that you and I might live in freedom today. So don't miss your opportunity this morning to live in your freedom, to walk out your freedom. So begin to confess your freedom today in Jesus' mighty name. We know that the right hand of God is power. And as you are seeing the anointing water being administered in Jesus' mighty name, you can see the lightning power of God beginning to operate in the lives of every person to uproot and to destroy every single darkness that has consumed their lives. We know that today their testimony is being restored. Even as you watch this woman, you can see the lightning power of God removing every single darkness in her life, causing every single sickness and disease to leave her body in Jesus' mighty name. And as you begin to witness the power of God moving in this place, know that your case cannot escape God's anointing. That whatever you see this morning, whatever you see happening here today, that you too can be a partaker of this divine healing, deliverance, salvation, and breakthrough. That you are not excluded from the mercy of God, because in His mercy you are healed. In His mercy you are delivered. In His mercy you are set free. So receive of His mercy today, because His mercies are new every morning. So begin to confess your freedom and say good morning to your freedom. Good morning to your good health. Good morning to your financial breakthrough. Good morning to restoration in your life and in your marriage, because today is the day of salvation in Jesus' name. Natural eyes, we see water, but with our spiritual eyes, we can see the fire of God burning every single evil spirit that has been tormenting the lives of these people. So we should not begin to see with our natural eyes, but let us see with our spiritual eyes and ask the Holy Spirit to open the eyes of our faith. For when the eyes of our faith are opened, it is the silencing of our fears. For we know that where the love of God is, that fear is not available, that fear is not welcome, because perfect love casts out all fear. So this morning, let's connect ourselves to the love of God. Know that Jesus Christ loves you deeply. He loves you dearly, and he desires your healing, deliverance, and breakthrough even more than you ever could. And he was willing to pay the price for you so that you can receive, so that you can be free, so that you can be next to him and be close to him, in Jesus' name.
I want you to repeat after me. Say, I am saved. Jesus is my Savior. Come on, say, I am healed. Jesus is my healer. Say, I am delivered. Jesus is my deliverer. Say, my past is over. Say, my pain is over. Say, my setback is over. Say, I will walk in the light of my testimony. May God's word a standard for your life, and go and sin no more. Amen. Come on, church, let's put our hands together for these lovely people. You may take your seats.